till I die. You can do what you wanna, live how you wanna, spin what you wanna, be who you wanna be. When you're stunner till I die. What is up? What is up, y'all? It's me, Kai Marie, and welcome to another video, y'all. I've been rocking my natural hair, y'all. I'm starting to, like, really just enjoy, you know, wearing my hair. The shrinkage is real because my hair is really long, but shrinkage means that it's healthy. That's what I learned. This is not really good lighting, y'all. I want to vlog. I felt like picking up the camera and talking to y'all. I never told you guys the story time about when I went to the Lagoon Fest here in Houston, Texas. So I saw it on Instagram and I thought, like, hey, this would be a nice getaway. Y'all, I've been itching for a vacation, and I try to find a vacation or something, a getaway, you know, locally where I'm at. So on Instagram, they were hyping this place up, like, you know, making it look really good. And, like, they told you clear, crystal blue water, all of this stuff. So I thought it would be a good idea for me and baby to go. And so I was so disappointed. It's just a big community pool, and you have to pay to get in. So I believe it was like 30-ish per person. So, on top of that, I had to buy the cabana, and the cabana was not cheap. It was probably like two something, and it was non-refundable. And so, I thought, you know, it would be good because you have to, because the seats there, they do have umbrella and seating areas, but it's like first come, first serve if you don't want to pay to, you know, sit. But the cabana, you can reserve and it's guaranteed, you know, it's yours and things like that. Oh my God, like, if I could rate the place is already a 3-star. I've learned to pay attention to the ratings online after this experience. So yeah, it was very much giving 3-star. Very dirty, you know what I'm saying? I even record, like, me walking into the swimming designated area, and you only get 4 feet, and that's not very high. It's probably like waist to your waist. And then you pretty much have to squat to even, you know, feel the water to your shoulder. I couldn't go as deep into the water anyway because of my predicament. But you have to go watch my video to see what predicament it was. But so the water was pretty much filled with sand. I showed on there how it looked as I was walking in and out the water. So it was just filled with sand. I went to go see my cabana. There was somebody spilled some drink prior to me even, like, settling in. Before I could even settle in, I see there's spilled drink on the floor, like some red type of looking Kool-Aid, I don't know. then you can see like all the chairs, cushion is all the range, the rain, or discombobulated all over the place. Just it was like it was getting pretty much dirty, you know what I'm saying? It was so dirty, and oh my God, and then it was like it was gonna be my first and my last, but I did wanted to tell y'all that was like the worst experience. They play over loud music. So if you it's not there for you to chill, relax, it kind of feels like you're at a damn concert. So it was like didn't like that. The lifeguards, they kept blowing the whistle like every 30 minutes, and that was getting annoying. They would throw they blew the whistle, like I just got there, they blew the whistle and they were like sweeping out the sand out of the water. They take brushes and sweep the sand out of the pool or whatever. There are some pros, you know what I'm saying, but I'm not really I really don't I feel like the con outweighed the pro. So yeah, it was just a bad experience. Just imagine like you rent something and what you rent is filthy. You know what I'm saying? And you're a first timer and this is your first time, your first experience there. And like what you pay for is just filthy. So that was I was so mad about that situation. And hence why I will never go back. And I personally would give it a 1-star rating. But I'm just going to just vent on my channel, and I'm not gonna, you know, I'm not gonna write my review on Google, 'cause I do that. Like when I'm mad, oh, I leave a review, but I'm not gonna leave a review. As much as they really deserve that 1-star review for me, I'm not gonna do it. I'm just explaining my story on how I purchased, you know, a cabana, a tent sitting designated area, and the chairs was all filthy. You could see like somebody was already sitting there, and I paid for that. You know what I'm saying? So basically, you mean to tell me I paid for sand on the deck? I paid for a spilled drink on the deck. I paid for somebody butt print. Wet butt print on the cushion seat. That's what you're trying to tell me? $200. That's what it gave me. So, yeah. Never again. No, thank you, Lagoon Fest. No, thank you. Never again. But, y'all, I just felt like I had to, like, tell y'all my story about that. But, yeah, because I was looking at my other videos. I was just now watching like my videos. I do that when I'm bored. I don't feel like playing a game or, you know, I'll watch my videos just for like memory. And I did tell you guys I was gonna give you a story time. So that's my little story there. But yeah, never again. But I'm always trying to seek another, you know, getaway or another adventure, you know. So hopefully, I'm just praying for that dream vacation, but hopefully next year I can possibly get away and swim and stuff. But yeah, y'all. But I'm gonna go to the next scene. I wanted to start. I wanted to try something, you know, just pick up the camera and vlog. The light is not good. I'm in my room. I got the light off, and I'm really using like my display lamp, to talk to y'all. But And then I'm sitting in my favorite chair, y'all. I could not stay out this chair, even after work. Like, this is my working chair, but as soon as I get off work, I will push my chair in my bedroom, and I'll just curl up in it, and I'll just lay in it, because it's just so soft. It's like laying in bed, but much better. It's softer than my bed. But anyway, y'all, I'm done rambling, because I can talk to y'all and just talk. So we'll go to the next thing on here, and keep watching, y'all. Thank y'all so much. That subscriber is going up. Y'all better blow this channel up. So thank you so much for everybody that subscribed, and continue, if you're new, subscribe, like, comment, y'all, and yeah, y'all can talk to me, you know, in the comments, so don't be shy, y'all. All right, so let's go to the next scene. Hi, my babies, it's me, Kymarie, and happy Sunday. It's a new day. I haven't had good night rest because I have some invaders, okay? And this has been happening since Friday, and today is Sunday. I'm at the end of my shift working, right? And I get an indication in my spirit, like, to look to my right. And I see a big cockroach, or you could say water bug. It was as big as my thumb. I am terrified of the sight of them. Me getting close in their perimeter, like me getting close to it, is out of the question. I be needing support to, like, get them things down, like, put them down, you know what I'm saying, to put an end to it. But, and it happened 3 times. It happened on Friday, then the next day I see another one, but thank God, that one was laid on its back and already dead. Oh, let me explain the first one. So the first one, when I saw it, like, on my right, this sucker ran under the refrigerator. Then it ran back out. And so I was scared. And my boyfriend was, like, coaching me on the phone because I was, like, freaking out. I was like, ah. And I was like, oh, my God, I'm scared. And so, man, heart racing, I'm sweating like bullets because it's huge, it's moving so freaking fast, and oh my God. So then I went to get the spray on my bedroom, and then I had the raid. I started spraying it because it came towards me, and I was trying to get it down, you know, like, you know. And so when I sprayed it, it got mad, and it started charging at me. Like, it just kept coming forward towards me, and I just kept spraying. Mind you, the can is half full, and so it was not putting it down fast enough for me. I emptied the can on that thing, and it finally like land on its back. Oh my God. Then the second one, the next day I see another one, and it's like in my living room, and it's on its back, and it looks like it's already done for, like it's already dead. Like, the issue resolved itself. I don't know how it got in. I don't know what happened, but it was just found dead. Then later Saturday, this was on Saturday, later Saturday, I'm in my bedroom just talking to my sister. Well, I talked to my boyfriend, talked to my mom, like everybody's trying to support me emotionally and psychologically because I was losing my, oh my God, my peace. I was just losing my peace, and my stress was was on me, okay? Because those things are ugly, and like the sight of them freaks me out. So the third day, and look at me, I'm still like checking my perimeter because I'm just feeling like that's gonna I just feel like, I don't know, I don't feel like it's over, like the war is still going. But anyway, so I'm on the phone with my sister, and we talking smack. That's just how our chemistry, how we talk, how we, how our, that's just our relationship. Like we talk smack to each other. So we were like talking, and she got mad at me because I sent her a picture of how big that thing was because she was like, you know how when you're in a panic, when you're panicking and they're telling you, oh, just go get it, just go kill it, end it, drop something on it, do something, do that. I can't do none of that. I don't want to see it. I don't want to be near it. It's kind of like I want the issue to resolve on its own. But we know that's not gonna work. So, but I can spray it, you know what I'm saying, and get it dealt with, done with. But anyway, so look at me, you're still looking around. So, my sister was talking smack. She was like, why you see me that picture? I'm so mad. Oh, you could have saved that picture for yourself. Oh, she was just so mad, right? Because she was like making light of the situation, like, oh, just go and deal with it. Go and squash it, go get it. And I'm like, you say it like it's so easy when, that's a big fear for me. So I sent her a picture and be like, yeah, what about this? Like, you see how big this is? You see how big this is? You think I'ma just casually go up to it and take care of it? So she was mad at me because I sent it. So after that, I'm just talking to her, and she's like, I hope one, she's playing. She was like, I hope one crawl on your face. I hope when you sleep, so crawl up the water bug crawl on your face. I'm like, oh, that's so, you violate, you out of line for that. You out of line for that. So hold on, y'all. So we talking, right? And then remember she was talking smack to me, telling, so I hope one crawl on your face while you sleep and stuff. So we just talk smack, and I'm like, you out of line. Don't wish that on me. And so I look over to my bedroom door at the bottom, like the floor, and it's another giant one. So this is number three. This is the third water bug. Or you want to say cockeye roach, that I see. Oh my God. And this makes me miss Colorado so much because Texas always got them darn roaches. But anyway, I'm still looking around, y'all, because I'm just like, I'm like traumatized because this is number three. And so this one, I didn't have the courage because I already went through one battle, and then I had went through the second battle on my own. And so when I saw this third one, I lost it. I was like, I can't do this. I cannot do this. So I called my boyfriend. Well, I text my boyfriend because he's at work, well, towards the end of his shift, and I'm like, babe, this is the third one. I'm scared. I need you. Come and help me. So he finally, and to mind you, my baby lives far from me. Like, my baby is, like, close to, like, 40 minutes. Traffic included, it could be an hour. But with no traffic, my baby is, like, 40 minutes away from me. So, he finally shows up. And he's just as, like, scared as me, but he's more brave than me. And so, he helped me. He was helping me clean up. Because I felt like it was coming from the laundry area. They love water. So, that's part of their source. You know, they need water, food, and then they like to multiply. But that's what they like. So they like to be by, they're not necessarily like in the water, but they like to be around water, moisture, and humidity. And, and I keep looking at the floor, y'all, because I am petrified. But, we're not supposed to live in fear. But y'all, that's something that I need deliverance from, and I am not there yet in that realm. But it's environmental. This is environmental because these apartments, the sewage is like it's like right there. Like when I step outside, the sewage drainage and the opening of it. It's like right there. Like when you walk out there, there's a little bit of grass area, then there's a sidewalk, and then there's the sewage right there. So of course, if I'm like right near the nest or their environment or what they like to live, of course they're gonna drive this way. Like they're gonna drive and come into the apartment units. And then on the other side of these apartments, there is a big circle where you can see that's the sewage, right? And on the circle, the sewage is open. Like, it's not like wide open, but it's a lid, but it's not. The lid has holes in it. And so the lids have holes in it. And so I don't know why it has like open bar. It's like a bar, iron bar, and it has some openings to where things can crawl out of it if it wanted to. And so this is an environmental issue. So the temperature, the weather is extremely hot. Yesterday we was in like the 103. You know, a little probably hotter than that, but we was in the hundreds degree weather and in the triple degree weather, and it was extremely hot. And me being anemic, I don't like to blow my cold AC that much because I get cold easily. But because of this issue, this problem, this matter, and they love heat, warmth, and all that, I was just making it comfortable for them. So I had to, you know, turn my AC on, make it cold. And so, man, I've been reading articles and stuff. It did not help me. But, 'cause they kept saying, oh, once you see one, you might see an infestation of them. And I don't believe in that because I've been here. There hasn't been no infestation or anything like that. I've been here for a while and it's not like I see signs of a whole colony of them in this apartment. It's more like I saw one here and there. So that means they came in to like, they were forced by force. Like they came in by force and they're trying to escape the heat or whatever. But man, this is it's crazy. But yeah, what I did was my laundry was very cluttered. My laundry room was extremely cluttered. So me and my boyfriend, we went and we cleaned out my laundry room. Let me show y'all. So yeah, so we cleaned out the laundry room because I thought this was like the issue. Like I thought like because in here, this is where they were coming from. Because, you know, I have, the washer and dryer. And then behind my dryer, there's a big old, hole or whatever. So, I was thinking it was coming from there. But ain't no telling. I don't know where they're coming from. I really don't. But I guess I say all this to say I'm about to clean up real good. So I could feel, you know, better, you know. So I'm about to sweep under my bed and lay some more like borax around the baseboard. I did spray around the baseboard to keep them out too. I'm doing whatever I can to not have that encounter. But I just know it's environmental. And I know, like, it's bound to happen because, why is there an open sewage, like, right there? They're bound to come this way and crawl up and come in. I'm gonna pray over this house and I'm gonna clean. I know God got me, and I bought a whole bunch of roach spray, so I'm not playing with this, you know what I mean? But yeah, that's what I've been dealing with, y'all. So, it's been unpleasant this weekend. And you know how you want to rest, but, you know, there are situations or matters like this that cause you not to rest and, like, keep you worried and up at night. This ain't no joke, you know what I'm saying? I pray and everything, but still, like, oh my God, I can't shake it off me. But anyway, I'm strong enough to clean up now. I got on some clothes. Normally, I be having on, like, a t-shirt and some shorts, but I got my t-shirt on, some pants, and my tennis shoes. I don't have no skin out because normally I have like some shorts on and a shirt chilling, but nah. Oop. But nope. I'm all dressed up, covered, and I'm about to clean up, y'all. I don't know if I'm going to show y'all, but I'm going to do that. I don't know. I'll probably do it off camera, but that's what I'm about to do, y'all. I had to tell y'all my story, though, because this is my diary vlog, and I'm keeping it real. This is what you got to deal with when you live in Houston, Texas. 60% of us have roaches, cacara roaches issues, because they want to cram you in units, and they want to build sewage and infrastructures right by your damn house so that the roaches, they drive up in here. So I think that's a setup for a disaster, and whoever did that is wrong for that. And I rest my case. But let me go ahead and get this over with, y'all. Let me go ahead and clean up. All right.
You know, a lot of girls be thinking my songs are about them, but this is not to get confused. This one's for you. Baby, you my everything. You all I ever wanted. We could do it real big. Bigger than you ever done it. You be up on everything. Other hoes ain't never on it. I want this forever. I swear I could spend whatever on it. Cause she hold me down every time I hit up. When I get right, I promise that we gon' live it up. She made me beg for it till she give it up. And I say the same thing every single time. I say you the fucking best. You the fucking best. You the fucking best. You the fucking best. You the best I ever had. Best I ever had. Best I ever had. Best I ever had.
say you the fucking.
Know you got a roommate, call me when there's no one there. Put the key under the mat and you know I be over there. I be over there, shout it, I be over there. I be hitting all the spots that you ain't even know is there. And you don't even have to ask twice. You can have my heart or we can share it like the last slice. Always felt like you were so accustomed to the fast life. Have a nigga thinking that he met you in a past life. Sweatpants, hair tied, chilling with no makeup on. That's when you're the prettiest, I hope that y'all don't take it wrong. You don't even trip when friends say you ain't bringing Drake along. You know that I'm working, I be there soon as I'm at home. Is she impatient in my waiting room? Never pay attention to the rumors and what they assume. And until them girls prove it, I'm the one that never get confused with. Cause baby, you my amen. You all I ever wanted. We could do it for a bit. Bigger than you ever done it. You be up on everything. Other hoes ain't never on it. I want this forever. I swear I can spend whatever on it.
She every time I hit up. When I get right, I promise that we gon' live it up. She made me beg for it till she give it up. And I say the same thing every single time.
I say, you the fucking best. You the fucking best. You the fucking best. You the fucking best. You the best I ever had. Best I ever had.
Sex, love, pain, baby, I be on that tank shit. Buzz so big, I could probably sell a blank this. When my album drop, bitches will buy it for the picture. And niggas will buy it too and claim they got it for they sister. Magazine, paper, girl, but money ain't the issue. They bring dinner to my room and ask me to initiate. She call me referee cause I be so official. My shirt ain't got no stripes, but I can make your pussy whistle. Like the Andy Griffith theme song. And who told you to put some jeans on?
Oh, let me turn this bed. Let me put y'all on something. Let me put something on ya. Now, I will highly recommend it. This is my first time. Maybe I'm late, but this is my first time using this brand. Murphy Cleaning Care Restores. And it's for concentrated wood cleaner. So it's for your wooden floors. When you're mopping your wooden floors, I highly, highly recommend this. This smells so good. It smells like soap, like, but a strong, clean, crisp soap. And it's lovely. It's a lovely smell to it. You don't need to add nothing to your mop water. All you need is warm water or hot water. And that Murphy, top tier. So had to share that with y'all. All right, my babies, let's take a look at what I got from Kroger's. I like their bags. Let's pick up. Grab the other stuff. First, I got some breakfast. So, and this is my grocery for a week. So, it's not a lot of food. Y'all know inflation and all that. But I got my French toast stick. Breakfast. What we got for breakfast? I have my tree grain bar is strawberry, so I can grab these in the morning and eat before work. Okay. Okay, I got some salmon for like dinner. I have more salmon for dinner. If y'all go back to my old video with me and my sister, we used this one. So I got this from Kroger's. It's a family size pack, so it should spread and last for me for quite a while. So this is gonna last me for, it's gonna spread for more than a week. I have some fried rice. Oh, I love these. These come in clutch all the time. I'm gonna open the box, because the box are pretty big and the bags are pretty small. So I'm gonna open the box for like space reason. You see how the bags are? They're frozen. All you need to do is get your skillet, put a little bit of oil in the skillet, and then fry it. Pan fry and dinner. And they're really good. So I might have this tonight. I got like 3 boxes, so I kind of went overboard with this, because it really did last me. Let me put this up. Man, I used to eat these all the time in high school, and they fill me up when I'm hungry. So I got the Totinos. Pepperoni. I got 2. Just 2. When I have a sweet tooth, I get this chocolate chip cookie, and this is the Pillsbury chocolate chip cookies. Always come in clutch when I have a sweet tooth. And then I got the beef barbacoa. I seen this on YouTube and I wanted to try it. I know you're supposed to keep it refrigerated, but I'm going to freeze it. It's already fully cooked, but I'm gonna go ahead and freeze this because, and you just boil the bag. But I'm going to freeze it because I don't plan on eating this no time soon. So it'll probably be like towards Thursday, Friday, and today's Sunday. So I'm going to freeze this. I think I am done with the... Oh yeah, I need to get some cayenne pepper to like spice up my meals, because I've been craving like a lot of spicy food. So just to give it a kick, I got this. This is the brand I got. It's nice. It's really nice. Cute little bottle, but I got it. Alright, and I'm gonna show you guys. Oh yeah, I used to drink these a lot when I was in Colorado. These are like the aloe vera, but this is the mango. I wanted to try it, but this is the one that I always get. But this is not the same brand that I got like in Colorado. I used to always drink aloe vera juice, and it's sweet. It's supposed to be sweet, and it hydrates me so well. So, and I've been feeling very hydrated lately, so that's why I got this. So I'm gonna toss these in a refrigerator. Well, I'm gonna just toss one in a refrigerator. I'm gonna toss this one in there, and I'm gonna drink on some of this today, but I gotta get chilled. now to our household items. I need to restock on my gloves. This is the old cedar, a size large. It's supposed to be a size large. Yeah. A large pair of old cedar gloves. And I like that barrier of protection of my hands. I don't like to clean with my bare hands. That's just my preference. It's my preference, you know what I'm saying? I don't like clean with my bare hand. That's always been the issue for me. So I got this to combat that issue. And I wear my old cedar hand glove and I wipe and clean and all that without the worry of anything else. I went and got some more trash bags. I got the 30 gallon hefty, and it has 56 of these. They come in clutch for throw trash away. And I gotta be mindful not to leave food and leave my bag open, because I used to always do that. Leave my bag open because of the critters issues that I told y'all earlier. Yeah, so next time I'm gonna start tying my bags and like putting them up. Then I needed to restock on some tissue for my nose, honey. This is supposed to kill cold and flu viruses. Because we're about to be in that season. It's right around the corner. So and then just because I need to blow my nose, so I did get some Kleenex. And it's got 4 packs, so that gives me 200 of the tissue. And that's about it, you guys. All of that was like $150 something. And that's expensive because I only got 19 items. So, and then this is only going to last me for like a week. And it's not like I'm going to have fish every single day. I try to spread out, you know, when I eat, you know, fish, salmon. So, yeah. I used to save my bags, but now I'm throwing them away. Because of, you know, the issue. The critter issue. So, instead of me having, like, you know, bags out, I'm going to start just investing in some Glades. These are like the small trash drawstring. And they have a smell too. I got these yesterday from Target. And this is cherry blossom. And I like that because even when I'm in my room chilling, I could kind of smell it. So, yeah. No more. I used to do this. I used to like collect my bags and put them all in one bag, right? And like I'll put it in the laundry room, and then whenever I need it, I go and grab it and put it in my little small bins, trash cans. I can't do that no more now that I have these critters coming in here. So now what I do is I just pull from this box here. It gives me at least I feel more secure because I know it's not like out in there like trying to stay warm. You know what I'm saying? Trying to stay warm with the clutter of bags. So I just go ahead and toss these bad boys and be done with it. I don't keep them no more. Nope. So yeah, I'm done with the show and tell that. Oh, I didn't show you this. I did get some more paper towels. Oh yeah. And I didn't show y'all the other. I did get that sparkling water, the ice sparkling water. So I did get some paper towels. This is a big pack. I didn't know it was going to come in like this. But yeah, it's like eight of these. 8 rolls. So I didn't know it was going to come like this. So I'm good for a couple of months. So that's good. So I got a big bundle of paper towels for my kitchen. And I use a lot of paper towels. I really do. So they come in handy. Other than that, y'all, that's all I got from Kroger's. And yeah. All right, babies. Y'all stay tuned because I'm going to take down my hair. I was trying to do a stretch method without using heat. And so, you know, today I clean. Right now I'm about to jump in the shower. And then after my shower, I'll do the reveal if this method worked for me or not. But yeah, I was trying to stretch out my hair, so I'm gonna be taking this down and then I'll show you guys how it looks, and then we'll close out, you know, the video, and we'll start on a new one, a new adventure, a new diary. So all right, loves, let me go take a shower. Thank you for staying this long on this video. This is another day. I'm just trying to close out the day. When I was taking down my hair, that was like in the morning. You can tell I have a little attitude. I was just reading myself. I'm like, girl, you is wrong for recording that with a little stank attitude. And it's funny because a lot of YouTubers do that. They wake up, They know darn well they ain't no morning person, and then they pull out the video, the camera and stuff, and I just be reading them like I just read myself. But anyway, the shrinkage is real. It shrinked back up, and I haven't been doing nothing to my hair lately, so I've been rocking my hair natural, y'all, at its most natural state, just loving myself, self-love babies, and I'm just here to close out the video. I love y'all. Love yourself, love others as yourself. Self-love, baby. Keep God first. And I will see you guys on another video. I'm so excited. New video coming out. Just stay tuned. Love you. What?